Hello friends, now we are going to discuss about the desalcination. Desalcination is a process of partial or complete demineralization of highly saline water, that is sea water, where we are going to convert the sea water into the potable water so that it can be used for domestic as well as industrial application. The important method of desalcination is, that is, reverse osmosis. Before going to discuss about the reverse osmosis, we have to first discuss about the osmosis process. Osmosis process means when the two concentrated solutions are separated from the semipermeable membrane, at that point solvent will move from the lower concentration to higher concentration and solute will move from the higher concentration to lower concentration. The movement of solvent through a semi-permeable membrane is used to balance the chemical potential. This is based on a difference in the chemical potential between two solutions, that is salt solution and water. As the membrane allow only water molecule, not salt, at that point, the salt water thus has greater chemical potential than water on other side of the membrane. To equalize the chemical potential, water diffuses the membrane from the water side to salt water side. That means water is moving from the lower concentration side to higher concentration side through semi-permeable membrane. This is called osmosis. Here in this animation, we are going to see the osmosis process. Here blue colored solution is solvent and this red molecules are whatever indicating that they are solute molecules. Blue color is water and here these red balls are salt ions present in the water. When this solution is separated by the low concentrated solution water, that time water will move through the lower concentration to the higher concentration side in order to balance the potential. Here that is we are going to call it as osmosis. Here water is moving from the lower concentration to higher concentration through semi-permeable membrane. That is what we are going to call it as osmosis. Next, we are going to discuss about the reverse osmosis. In the reverse osmosis, we are going to apply the pressure which is greater than the osmotic pressure. Diffusion in the opposite direction from higher concentration to lower concentration. That means here, because of applied pressure which is greater than osmotic pressure, water will move from higher concentration to lower concentration side. That means highly saline water to the less salt containing water or demineralized water side. Here in the figure, this is the semi-permeable membrane which separates the pure water and brackish water or sea water. The concentration of sea water is high and concentration of pure water is less. When we are going to apply the pressure by using piston, that pressure must be greater than osmotic pressure. That time, instead of moving the water lower concentration to higher concentration, because of applied pressure, water is moving in the reverse direction, that is higher concentration to lower concentration. And this semi-permeable membrane will allow only water molecule can pass through it. Because of that, whatever the water is coming outside from the membrane, it is free from the dissolved salt. In this way, we are going to convert the sea water into the potable water. Here, two sides are there. One side pure water is there, other side sea water is there, which is separated by the semi-permeable membrane. By using piston, we are going to apply the pressure, that pressure which is greater than the osmotic pressure. In the normal osmosis, this water has to move from the lower concentration to higher concentration. But in this process, because of applied pressure which is greater than osmotic pressure, water is moving in reverse direction through the semi-permeable membrane from the higher concentration to lower concentration through the semipermeable membrane, and this semipermeable membrane will allows only water can pass through it, not ions. Because of this, the whatever the water is coming outside, it is the pure water or potable water. In this way, we are going to desalinate the sea water in order to convert into potable water for domestic and industrial applications. The advantage of reverse osmosis are: it is economical, simple, continuous and compact method. The process needs extremely low energy. It has long life and membrane is easily replaceable. It is possible to connect a number of tubes in parallel to get the more fresh water. Ionic, not ionic, colloidal, high molecular weight organic matter can easily removed here because membrane will allow the water can pass through it, but many ions will not pass through that membrane, so that they can easily removed here. This advantage of this reverse osmosis is the colloidal silica is not removed by the process. The water is usually acidic. The some critical contaminant are not removed, like volatile organic chemicals, chlorine, chloramines and pharmaceuticals. These cannot be removed by the reverse osmosis.